Breaking news out of the Big Ten, Jim Harbaugh has been suspended for being caught driving strippers and doing cocaine. Yeah, what? Oh, wait, no, that's not it. That's not it. What is it? The Big Ten, wait, he wasn't caught with strippers and cocaine. What? Oh, he was caught stealing signs? What is going on? Breaking news out of Michigan, the Big Ten is expected, this is the rumors, to discipline Michigan for the in-person scouting and signs dealing. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Wait. Jim Harbaugh is getting suspended because of in-person scouting and signs dealing of other teams, which every team in the NCAA does. And also, if your signs are getting stolen, do better. Change them up. I mean, come on. What are we doing here, Big Ten? This is ridiculous. Okay, so here's a story out of ESPN that's breaking. They will prohibit Jim Harbaugh from being on the sideline for the rest of the season, according to Pete Thamel. I don't know how you say that name. Anyways, he'll be allowed to coach during the week. So from that little limited information, it sounds like he's able to be at practices all week, but not be at the games. Let's go over to ESPN and check out the article that broke over there. Big Ten to ban Michigan's Jim Harbaugh from the field. The Big Ten is expected to discipline Michigan for the in-person scouting and ongoing sign-stealing investigation and will prohibit Jim Harbaugh from being on the sideline until the conclusion of the regular season. So that means, from what I'm seeing here, that means any bowl game or potential playoff games, Michigan's okay and Harbaugh's okay. Harbaugh will be allowed to coach during the week, according to sources. The Big Ten's punishment comes after Conference Commissioner Tony Petitti said, I don't even know if I said that right. You guys know I suck with names. Sent Michigan a notice of disciplinary action as required by the sportsmanship policy in the event it becomes clear that an institution is likely to be subject to penalties. So without even doing a full investigation and having proof or whatever proof they think they have, they're just going to say, yeah, we think you're probably going to be guilty. So we're just going to go ahead and suspend you now. All right. Michigan sent its response to the notice on Wednesday. That 10-page response, according to sources, focused on urging Petitti to respect due process and argued that a sanction at this stage would be breaking the league's bylaws in an effort to lay the groundwork for potential legal intervention, which is makes sense. When have we ever seen? First of all, once again, I can't state this enough. It's not like Jim Harbaugh is out there doing cocaine with strippers, even if he was. I mean, okay. I mean, good for him, whatever. I mean, do what you got to do. But I mean, it's not like he did something like egregious here. They're accused of stealing signs and having some people scouting some of their other opponents, you know, in person at games, a little bit of, I mean, that's a rules violation. Okay. But they're making this such a big story. Let's just call it what it is. Everyone hates Michigan. Everyone hates Jim Harbaugh, especially everyone in the Big Ten, and they want to go after him. But really, what they don't realize is this is going to destroy the Big Ten. This is what happens when you give into like these, like what we see with the woke ideology. It eats itself. You feel like you're good. You feel like you're virtue signaling. You're doing a good cause. You're going after Jim Harbaugh in Michigan, and you're attacking him. What you don't realize is that you give into the crowd, you give into the mob, and then it's going to eat you eventually. And that's what we're seeing. Hell, look at Marvel right now. Look at Disney. All that shit is going down the toilet. Their stock prices, everything like that is terrible. Same thing here. The Big Ten is about to implode. They just added all these teams to the Big Ten, and now you're going after one of your biggest names. Let's be honest. College football is better when Michigan is good. You go after Michigan here. By the way, a team that's in contention, undefeated and in contention for a title, you just completely screwed yourselves. Like, this does not help their chances to win a title, right? Not having their coach on the sideline, also a huge distraction. Doesn't help them there. Doesn't help them at all. And also, if this is how you're going to attack Michigan, you know Harbaugh's leaving. He's gone. No one's going to want to coach for Michigan. No one good, that is, at least. Now you just made Michigan a terrible team in this conference. That does not help your ratings. That does not help your conference. Oh, by the way, now that you went so severe on Michigan for this, just wait till the other teams, wait till the Ohio States, the Penn States, the Iowas, every single team in the Big Ten is doing this. And you find out that they are doing this. And now you've got to go after them. And if you don't, you're a hypocrite. And then you're going to be called out even more. You just imploded. This is the seed that just keeps on spreading. So Big Ten, congrats. You know, congrats. If this is what you want to do, this is how you want to ruin your conference. This is how you want to go after Michigan just to get at Harbaugh because you don't like Harbaugh. Well, okay, it's your choice. But the Big Ten is done. The Big Ten is dead. It doesn't matter that they're bringing a bunch of teams next year. The Big Ten is toast. It's going to eat itself alive. You don't see the SEC doing this. No, you don't. We all know there's shady stuff going down in the SEC, but hey, they just keep winning, baby. They just keep winning, and no one rats any, either team out, any team out in there. So, hey, we'll see. I predict this is going to hurt the Big Ten. It's going to hurt them. It also gives Jim Harbaugh another excuse. Michigan doesn't make the playoffs or doesn't win a title this year. Well, that's because the Big Ten went after him. If they do win it, he says it's because of you guys. We came after you. So we'll see. Michigan is set to the Big Ten's discipline would not conclude the ongoing NCAA investigation. That's the other thing about this. There's an ongoing investigation. How many times have we seen in the NCAA when there's an investigation like this, something big in the middle of the season? Oh, hell, we're towards the end of the season. They just punt it to the offseason. They'll say, we'll handle this in the offseason and we'll come down hard on them. So this is so weird that they're going to step in right here, especially when we're a couple weeks away from Ohio State versus Michigan. I mean, come on. The game that everyone wants to see in the Big Ten. And now you're going to throw this shit out there? I don't get it, man. I don't get it. The Wolverines, 9-0, are ranked third in the college football playoff and have three regular season games left against Penn State this weekend, then Maryland, and then finally against Ohio State. And that's exactly what I was going to pull up next. Look at this. So Harbaugh potentially could be sidelined depending if the court decides to step in. You got Michigan here against Penn State, Michigan against Maryland, and then obviously the big game, Michigan home against Ohio State, which Harbaugh right now cannot be a part of. So what is this, the day after Thanksgiving? Is that right? Or is that 2 days after? When is Thanksgiving this year? Either way, Thanksgiving week, let's say that. We'll see. We'll see. This is interesting. But hey, Big Ten, the hell are you doing, man? Rip to the Big Ten. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Is the Big Ten done? Is it over? Is this a mistake? Or do you think Harbaugh, Michigan is getting what they deserve? Comment below. Like this video. Subscribe to the channel. And I'll catch you guys on the next stream.